We shall take one more problem on transform analysis of LTI system. The problem is a causal system. Again, it's a causal system, has the input x of n is this, and output y of n is 1 by 3 power n u of n. Okay, what is my aim? I need to find system function h offset, I need to find impulse response h of n, and I need to check whether the given system is stable or not. Okay, so you should try to solve it. Solution: what is h offset? H offset is y offset by x offset, right, is equal to, so what is y offset? Z transform of y of n, right? Z transform of y of n divided by x offset is z transform of x of n. So this is equal to, what is the z transform of 1 by 3 power n u of n? It's a causal system, so it is z divided by z minus 1 by 3 divided by, what is the z transform of the sequence x of n if it is a causal system? 1 by 2 power n u of n, it is z divided by z minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 times again, so the, this is I can use time shift properties to solve this, right? So what is the z transform of 1 by 2 power n minus 1 u of n minus 1? So I can write this as z transform of unshifted version of the sequence 1 by 2 power n u of n multiplied with z power minus 1. Okay, why minus 1? Because it is n minus 1 and n minus 1, time shift property, correct? No. Okay, so what is the z transform of 1 by 2 power n u of n? It is z divided by z minus 1 by 2 into z power minus 1. So z power plus 1 minus 1 cancels out, so I end up with 1 divided by z minus 1 by 2. So 1 divided by z minus 1 by 2. So therefore, if h offset is equal to, so I can simplify this, numerator is z divided by z minus 1 by 3 whole divided by, so since z minus 1 by 2, z minus 1 by 2 common, it is, this will become z minus, numerator is z minus 1 by 4 divided by z minus 1 by 2. So this I can write it as z divided by z minus 1 by 3 into z minus 1 by 2 divided by z minus 1 by 4. Correct, no? And this is equal to z into z minus 1 by 2 whole divided by z minus 1 by 3 into z minus 1 by 4. So what is this? This is h of z, right? So what is the next step? Next step is to bring this in the form of, basically I have to make sure that it is positive power of z, since all are positive power of z, so I don't have to worry. So next step is to bring this z to the left hand side. So what I end up with, x of h of z by z, and this is not there. So what I end up with, z minus 1 by 2 divided by z minus 1 by 3 and z minus 1 by 4. Now I have to perform the partial fraction expansion, right? So what do we have? H of z by z is equal to a divided by z minus 1 by 3, z minus 1 by 3 plus b divided by z minus 1 by 4. Okay, so where, what is the formula to find a? A is denominator of a, z minus 1 by 3 into x of z by z at z is equal to, so 1 by 3, and b is z minus 1 by 4 denominator of b into x of z by z divided by z is equal to 1 by 4. So if you solve for a and b, you get a as minus 2 and b as 3. Just check these values. So what do we have? H of z by z is equal to, put this value of a and b here, so minus 2 divided by z minus 1 by 3 plus 3 divided by z minus 1 by 4. So h of z by, okay, to take this z to the other side, so minus 2 into z divided by z minus 1 by 3 plus 3 into z divided by z minus 1 by 4. Okay, now I have to take inverse z transform on both sides. So it's a causal sequence, so all the inverse Z transform should be in terms of right sided sequence. Okay, so h of n, inverse Z transform of h of z is h of n minus 2 into, this is 1 by 3 power n u of n plus 3 into, this is 1 by 4 power n u of n. So this is the impulse response. So I need to find impulse response. I'm done. I'm supposed to find system function h offset. That is also done, right? Which is our system function? System function is this equation, right? So h of z is equal to z into z minus 1 by 2 whole divided by z minus 1 by 3 into z minus 1 by 4. So before you take this z to the other side, that will be our system function h offset. Okay. So I'm done with finding h of n. I'm done with finding h offset. What is the next thing I need to do? I need to check for stability. How do we check for stability? So if all the poles are lying inside the unit circle, then the system is stable. Why? Because it's a causal system, right? So we have two poles. One pole is at z is equal to 1 by 4. The other pole is at z is equal to 1 by 3. Somewhere here. 1 by 3. So our unit circle is here. So since all the poles are lying inside the unit circle, so the system is, it's a stable system. So okay, we'll take up one more problem, but I'm not going to solve it in detail. I'll give you an idea and I'll give you the intermediate result. You solve it and check your answers. Okay, a system has impulse response. They have given actually impulse response. They have given output y of n. So in our case, I need to find the input x of n. Basically, they used to give input and they used to give output. We are supposed to find its impulse response. Here, they have given us impulse response. They have given us the output. Our aim is to find x of n. Okay. So I'll give an idea how to solve it. So what is h of z? H of z is system function. It is given by y of z divided by x of z. So our aim is to find, get x of z. Once you get x of z, I can take its inverse z transform so that I get x of n. Okay. So this is what is x of z from this? X of z is what? Y of z divided by h of z. Okay. And this is equal to z transform of y of n. Y of n is this and divided by z transform of h of n. And what is h of n? H of n is this. Okay. So once you get z transform of y of n and h of n, you get polynomial in terms of z in the numerator, polynomial in terms of z in the denominator, which is our x of z, which is of the form x of z is equal to z cube minus z square plus 1 by 4 z divided by z into z minus 1 by 2 into z plus 1 by 2 z into z minus 1. Okay, this is z minus 1, z into z minus 1. So this is a polynomial we get as x of z. Okay. Once you get x of z, what is the next step? I have to bring one z in the numerator to the left hand side so that this is in the form of x of z by z form. Okay. So and you have to perform the partial fraction expansion. So the partial fraction expansion, when you do, the value of a what you get is minus 1 by 2. Value of b what you get is 1 by 6. Value of c what you get is 4 by 3. You just check it. Okay. And after performing inverse z transform, x of n is 1 by 2 delta of n plus 1 by 6 u of n plus 4 by 3 into minus 1 by 2 power n u of n. So this is the input to the system.